The Supreme Court today has passed a crucial order in the Rafale deal case. The apex court has agreed to take all the documents on record which were earlier published by the newspaper The Hindu. The apex court bench led by Chief Justice of India Ranjan Gogoi has unanimously passed this order and agreed to take all of those documents on record. The apex court also disagrees with all the contentions raised by the central government that argued that all these documents are protected under the Official Secrets Act and they should not be put on the record of the Supreme Court. This is a review petition against the December 14 judgment in the Rafale case, which has been filed by petitioners in the Supreme Court. It is being heard in an open court right now, which is an aberration from the usual practice. And the Supreme Court from here on will decide the course forward. It is going to look at these documents and adjudicate whether the earlier order, which was passed by the Supreme Court, needs any tweaking or any substantial changes at all. All of these documents were primarily published by the newspaper The Hindu. Also, certain other news agencies and websites had put out these file notings, the cabinet notings, the internal documents and the letters which were exchanged. Now, one of the prime arguments of the petitioners in this case, in the review petition, citing these documents has been that there was some amount of parallel negotiation which the Prime Minister's office was doing in the Rafale deal. Let's look at the key arguments that the central government, represented by Attorney General Mr. Venugopal, presented before the Supreme Court during that hearing. One of the prime and the most cited argument of the Attorney General was the concern around national security. Attorney General time and again reminded the Supreme Court bench led by Chief Justice of India that the apex court should not interfere in this matter because this is a matter pertaining to national security and may jeopardize relations with the foreign countries, with many of the foreign countries with whom we have diplomatic relations and ties. The centre also argued that all of these documents were in fact stolen, quote unquote. This was the word that the central government had used in the court. And the court was also informed that some amount of investigation is still underway as to how these documents were leaked in the first place. And secondly, they are also mulling action against the newspapers and the media organisations which chose to publish this material. The Attorney General, in fact, argued that these documents are classified. Putting them on record in the Supreme Court would jeopardize the national security and also something that the Supreme Court should not meddle into as the government is currently investigating about these leaks. Now, in this election season, this entire controversy, of course, is going to have political implications with the principal opposition party, the Congress party, using Rafale deal as one of the biggest charges of corruption on the Modi government. While technically speaking, today's judgment merely takes these documents on record for scanning them, for examining them, for seeing whether there is any evidence that can affect the earlier judgment, the 14 December judgment that was earlier passed by the Supreme Court. The apex court will have to see that whether these documents at all make a ground, a prima facie ground, for some sort of investigation that has been asked by the petitioners in this case.